Let the steaks come to room temperature, about 30 minutes.
Love is a burning thing.
Meanwhile, preheat the oven to 400 degrees. Generously season both sides with salt and pepper. Ring. Set them aside as you heat the pan and wash your hands. Heat the pan over medium-high flame. The pan is heated properly when water beads as it's sprinkled in. Add a tablespoon and a half of clarified butter. Place the steaks in the center of the pan, making sure there's enough room between them. Let the steaks sear for 3 minutes on each side. As they cook, they develop a crust, which will help release them from the pan. If they still stick, they're not ready to be flipped. Keep an eye on the heat and lower the flame if the pan gets too hot. If the pan burns, we can't make a sauce from the drippings. Transfer the pan to the oven for 7 minutes. We prefer our steaks medium rare, so we cook them to 127 degrees, which is about 7 minutes in the oven. For the most accurate way to check the doneness of a steak, take its internal temperature. Remove the steaks from the oven and transfer to a clean plate. Rest your steaks by tenting them with foil for 10 minutes. As they rest, their internal temperature will rise. The steaks leave behind a crust of browned bits, meat juices, and seasonings in the bottom of the pan. The technical term for these browned bits is the fond, which is the foundation of the pan sauce. Return the pan to medium flame and add minced shallots or crushed garlic to boost the flavor, and saute for a few seconds. The next step is to loosen and dissolve the fond with either wine or stock or a combination of both. This is called deglazing. Pour a small amount of wine into the pan and use a wooden spoon to scrape up the brown bits. The wine will dissolve the fond and begin to make the sauce. This is especially cool because it cleans off the bottom of the pan as you make the sauce. At this point, you can add any herbs and the rest of the liquid to the pan. Bring the liquid to a boil, then lower the heat to simmer. We want to reduce the amount of liquid in the pan, which will thicken and concentrate the flavors. Simmer until the liquid level has reduced by half. For some sauces, we just add a small amount of butter at the end. This improves the body of the sauce. But for a more traditional gravy consistency, we would add a thickening agent to help. Before you strain, add any of the collected juices from your resting plate to the sauce. If you desire a smooth and elegant pan sauce, we recommend you strain out the herbs and shallots. It's just a quick little sauce you can drizzle over your steak.